No, prije sonce je odrk jak odlaš. They say that there will be tomorrow the sun, so hey, we must film something again.
Yes.
Friends, welcome to the Petrinčić Brothers RC channel.
Well, this is the seventh video in 2 days now, eh?
Yours, I mean, this is amazing. I mean, this year we are really productive, eh? I don't think that we have filmed so many videos in the past.
No.
I don't even have time to post them all. That's interesting. But hey, we must take advantage of this while we can, because who knows what will happen tomorrow, so you must have fun today. Like I always tell you, don't wait nothing. Right now, pause this video and order yourself something, eh? It doesn't matter what. Or make yourself a paper plane. The plane must be in your life.
Who cares what it is as long as you enjoy it.
Hey, the point is in the fun, and that's it, eh? And of course, welcome to the channel when we have dedicated this to the RC planes. The channel when we don't edit nothing, what you see is what you get. We don't pretend here to be professional pilots, because we are not. We are filming this from an amateur point of view, although we have tested more than 200 planes. But still, every time I go fly and I do maiden flight, I do that on the camera, and that is like the first time. I can't pretend to be professional on the maiden flight. I could make a video, we will prepare the plane, fly the plane 10 times, and then film the video. What?
Nothing.
What video?
Nothing, just babble forward.
And then pretend to be... But what video again?
Nothing, eh?
And then... What do you see?
No.
You should distract me with that.
Okay.
Once again. And pretend to be professional because we're not. And of course, the point of this channel at the
end. Well, actually, you are professional at something, eh?
Yeah.
At babbling, eh?
Yeah, of course. Yours, one thing that I have become professional in these last 4 years, and that is in the talking, eh? And I can talk 24/7 on the camera without any problems. That is why, if you are expecting to come here and expect the 3-minute videos, well, this channel is not 3 minutes crafts. For that, you will have to go somewhere else, eh? Here, you want to talk, eh? And to explain, of course, viewers, we do have fun here. The point of this is to having the perfect fun, but we also try to give you good informations, and we want to show you the options, and that's the point. We never say, you must click on that right now. But who cares on what you click? The point is that you do click, and that you have fun at the end, and that's it, and I will stop to talk right now, Captain Block. And now I will come to this, the famous question on this channel. What will we see in this show, in this video? Today we will test and see for the first time another beautiful and sexy plane from the E-Flight that you can get on the Horizon Hobby, or maybe some other store somewhere else. Of course, you will have the link below. If you will click from this link, hey, we will get a few points and that's it, eh?
Yes.
Good, and we will be able to buy another plane again in the future. But the point is that this today we have the Air Tractor. Now what's the point here, eh? The foam plane that can run on 3-cell or 4-cell, of course I will run this on 4-cell at the beginning, because we all know that more cells mean more performance, and of course, but if you want to fly scale low and slow and sexy, you can even fly it on 3-cell. It has the range of the batteries from 2200 to 3200, from 3-cell to 4-cell. I will fly this on 4-cell on the maiden flight with the 3200 battery. And maybe later we will also try to fly it on 3-cell to see the difference. Now the point is that this is 1.5 meter wingspan, beautiful and sexy scale plane, because the plane like this in fact does exist, and
yes,
we use it to crop the
to dust the crops.
To spray the crops. Now this factory I can see here. It was founded, the Air Tractor, because I have thought that the Air Tractor is the plane, that this plane is the Air Tractor. But the Air Tractor, I think that in fact is the name of the company.
Yeah, because it's a tractor for the air, eh?
Yeah, the working horse for the air, and that means, and this plane...
There's a pilot inside, eh?
Yeah, of course it is, viewers. Now I will tell you, and listen to me good. I mean, many will say, this is cheap, that is expensive, I don't know what. Because whatever brand of the planes we show on this channel, there is someone that will say, I love it, and someone will say, well, that is too expensive and I don't know what. Hey, it's up to you if you click or not. But I will tell you, like I always say with the E-Flight planes, they are not cheap, but that also means that the quality is good. because these planes by now, from all the e-flight planes that we had by now, the only thing that you have to do with them is to unbox them, assemble them and fly. When you take out of the box these planes, you don't have to worry, I will have to fix this first, I will have to check, replace that servo first, and I don't know what, this is missing, that is missing. By now, from my experience, I'm always saying from my experience, these planes are a piece of art.
No, just...
Now, I was saying about this plane, what the point of this, this can be your first scale low wing plane. If you were flying, because to become an RC pilot, yeah, papa, what's with your captain? I have to say,
no, I didn't say anything, gay.
I can see in your eyes that you want me to unbox something.
I'm just wondering if you can do.
The things that I have to say. If you want to become an RC pilot, you can't just fly an EDF jets. There is the way to become a good pilot, and you must start with the simple planes. Usually, you start with some high wing plane. And then when you know to fly that plane good, then this can be your first low wing plane, because the low wing planes do behave different.
Yes.
And after this, you can switch to beautiful and sexy warbirds that we all love, because warbirds are even more difficult to fly.
Yes.
And that's it. So this is the in between stage from that day. Your first scale low wing plane. And now I think Captain Blush and my friends, it's time that I finally take it out.
Yes, at 7 minutes.
The plane.
At 7 minute mark, eh?
Well, hey, the things need to be said, and that is why this channel, we can't film less than 30 minutes. And I'm sorry, viewers, but that's just the way of life here, eh? I can't, eh? Wait, I think that there is plane.
Yes, like this, yes.
Both sides?
Huh? Wait, I can help you.
I don't want to ruin the box, because...
Wait, I'll grab the box here.
Uh-huh, grab the box.
Wait, now do it.
Is it?
Yes.
Because sometimes you need the box, don't throw it away.
Oh,
because
you have created a vacuum, eh?
Yeah, maybe during the winter you won't fly it, but in fact, of course, hey, I just hope that in the future, and believe you me that, I have the skis, and I will put the skis on this if we will have snow, because this will be one perfect candidate to try it on the skis. And you also, but what did you see?
I told you, optional.
Yeah, but I thought that the optional is just the floats.
Hey, I told you before the filming, optional skis and floats.
Hey, but this is it, eh?
Yes.
Yeah, but do you see this? I mean, I do have the skis.
And the tail wheel.
Yeah, because that I didn't saw by now, that you have the option for the tail ski. Now that would be the total sexiness there.
Any mini ski.
Yow. Oh, I just wonder where to start to unbox this. Maybe on this side.
Well, start somewhere.
Let's see this for the first time and let's see what's here. Because I think that the plane
here is the wing. Here is the wing.
Oh.
Like open a Pandora box. Eh?
But viewers.
Hey, what am I seeing here?
What is? Show. For this e-flight, because what can be more simpler than to have the connectors on the wings? I mean, this is amazing. Now show how the plane comes packed. I mean, this is it.
Tell
you can
you.
See right now here, like I have tell you that with the e-flight there are no excuses, and that's it.
Well, now start with the nose of the plane.
I mean, viewers, just to take out the plane from the box, for me this is such a joy. I mean, I really enjoy. I feel like a 6-year-old kid.
Yes, next time bring some tissue, say.
Why?
Kleenex.
Yeah, but I'm really so excited, viewers. Some of you maybe don't understand.
Baby wipes.
You don't understand the passion for the planes, but planes for me, I don't know. I have such a special bond with the RC planes, and it's interesting that I'm in this hobby just for 5 years, and I'm really sorry.
It's getting to the sixth now, yes.
I'm really sorry that I didn't start it before. So that is why I want all of you to understand, do click quick, don't wait nothing, because later you will be sorry for all the years that you have lost in this. Now, of course, gets back to the plane.
Yes.
A beautiful, sexy free blade prop. Now look at this with the beautiful, sexy spinner, and of course, how do you call this? The, what is this? I always forget. The shaft, or what is this? How do you put this? Yeah, this aluminum part, what's this?
Well, this is the aluminum, yes.
Yeah, aluminum.
Machined aluminum.
Aluminum is something that you put on the motor. I recall it like this. Hey. I mean, viewers, we're still struggling with the correct words in this hobby because you must understand that English is our third language.
A prop adapter, what are you thinking, eh?
Yeah, you have just remembered this and now you're
protecting. No, I was waiting for you to say something.
Yeah, yeah. Prop adapter, of course, beautiful and sexy free blade prop that I will put here where the beginning of the blade will be. Yes. And of course, I will paint this in my beautiful and sexy white stripes on. So this is it, let's go to the next part that we can see here are the stuff that you get with the plate and you can see here how fast again this assembly will be. Yes. Now of course, we will assemble this plane again later after this filming on the video when Captain Blush will be the star and I can already see Captain Blush, look, that you will not have much work to do. I mean, look at this, eh? What is inside? A few screws or what?
Yeah, few screws. Ah, now I know what this is, eh?
What?
You will use this, you will put this under the tail wheel, and you will use this when you will have floats on.
Ah.
So is it push-pull system for the rudders?
But you can see here, no, no, look, I will take it out what you have. Look, a few strings. For this, springs, for this, you have the tail wheel. You have the bind plug, two screws, and of course, I think the carbon is for the back of the plane, and that's it. Eh? Now this, I mean,
yes.
I mean, they really do a good job. Eh? If light viewers, you will have, you still have to do something. You don't have to do much, but that something little that you have to do at that time, you will bond with your plane because then you get to know each other with each other and love each other. And look at this, of course, a carbon bar for the wings.
Yes.
Now let's take out the first wing and let's see the quality of this because even though I know the quality of E-Flight planes, I still surprise myself every single time.
Because, oh yeah?
Yeah,
you surprise yourself every day.
What?
You surprise yourself every day.
Well, hey.
Well.
Every time I open the plane from the E-Flight, yeah. I mean, look at this and you will see the quality. Look at this, eh? The paint job on this, do you see this?
Yes.
And not just that, but Captain Blush has already shown you.
Look, it even
the
says
plugs.
The pointer. It points to the
to plugs
the
that you don't
front
have
front of the plane.
Yeah, you don't have to screw with those wires. And of course, you have here the navigational lights and the strobing lights. I mean, this is amazing. The bottom of the wing, the servos already all pre-installed for you. Hey, you don't have to do
am
nothing.
Am I seeing things?
What? Tell me quick.
A Metal Gear servo.
Is it?
Yes. Well, yes. The aileron servo is Metal Gear. Look at this.
Well, this is something, eh?
A salute E-Flight.
Now, you can see an
E-Flight,
E-Flight the Horizon Hobby for this, because many times on great and expensive planes, you still get cheap plastic gear servos, but not this time, eh? And look at this, of course, you can see here already, look at the hinges inside. Not just the foam hinges that can break from time to time. And look at this.
Oh, splat flips, eh?
The splat flips.
No, these are not splat flips.
Yeah, the splat flips, but look with on. The slot. Yeah. And do you know what this means? Do you see this? Because the air goes here and here. Now that means that this plane will also have the stall capability.
Yes.
Short takeoff and landing. I mean,
yes.
I'm impressed right now. Of course, on this side, we also have the wheels. We will check that the size of the wheels. And already I can see, I mean, look at the size of this. Now, this will handle any kind of runway.
This is what? We will check it quick. Hey.
This will handle any kind of runway. And look at this.
Give it here.
It will.
I will use centimeters. That is 9 centimeters.
Yeah, almost 10.
Yes, almost. So this is 3 and I don't know something.
Yeah, oh, look
inches.
At this, hey. Hey, Captain Blush, we have the ruined runway, and even on our runway, even if the grass will not be totally cut it off, look, this will handle the truth, hey. Now, of course, this is on one side. I will put this back. And now let's check, of course, the other side. I mean, this is some package, huh?
Yes.
I love this kind of packaging.
Like this.
Let's see what we have here. The unboxings are so great. I would unbox planes every day, every single day. And this, we have, this has become an art on this channel.
Of course.
For this, I'm a salute. The Bible of every plane. Don't throw this plane.
Look at this sexy front page.
Even here they have done.
Look,
the scenery that you see.
Do it silo.
Yeah. The corn. And this will be one sexy looking plane. I can't wait to see it on our runway. And of course, in the summer, Captain Blush, we will film the video when we will have the corn on our runway. I will fly above the corn in the dusk. Eh? Can you imagine this? Eh? Of course, you have a few stickers that you can stick on something. Eh? Maybe on your plane, or I don't know, maybe on your box for the radio, or something like that.
Yes.
We will go now, of course, to the back stabilizer.
Uh-huh. Ooh, supports.
Oh.
Yes, of course. They go onto the bottom. Look at this.
Oh. Yeah, but look at this. When have you seen something like this to have already on the plane? Look at this. On the hinge.
Uh-huh.
So you don't have to screw much.
Uh-huh. Again, hinges inside.
Even here you have the hinges. I mean, this is amazing. This, my friends, is amazing. And hey, I think that we will start to talk different about the E-flight, hey.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, many, many pilots, I know all the time that they are made beautiful planes. And of course, this again, it will be here. Uh-huh. You can see here, I can already see the carbon bar.
Yes.
We'll go inside here, which of course we will see on the unboxing. Look at this.
Assembly.
On the assembly, and it just clicks together and that's it. Now, of course, this is the back. Let's go to the next part. I will put it like this.
Yes.
So the plane will get a little shape. The second wing, of course, is the same as the first one, but we will take it out for the filming because we must see. Look at this. I mean, this will be something that you will see in the air, huh, Captain Blush? Oh. I don't think that the camera will blur this time. Look at this. All pre-assembled for you, and the hinges. Do you see these hinges? This is the barn door. These are different flaps like on the usual planes. They barn. Don't work the same. These are for the stall capabilities of the planes. Because of this.
Barn door?
Barn doors, yeah. Barn door flaps, they call it.
Ah.
Because they open like a barn door.
Yes.
Now, anything else here? Or we are on the fuselage? Yeah, of course we are. Because like you have seen, you don't have to do much to have fun with this.
I can't wait to assemble this, eh?
Tell me, Captain Blush.
Yes.
But I can't wait to take it out right now because...
Yeah, the plane, yes.
Yeah, look how sexy it looks.
Wait.
Yeah.
This is it.
I mean,
now take it out slowly.
Look at this perfection, eh?
Oh, yeah. Look at this. Hey, huh? Only click in, like, click, click.
Hey, and they have it. Such... I mean, it's amazing, eh? You don't see such a variety of beautiful solutions on the planes on other manufacturers. You really don't see viewers, and I'm not just saying that. I mean, everybody look, they try to make your life as
easy,
simple, as sexy as possible, because the point is on the runway with your friends that you're having fun, not to screw to assemble the plane, I don't know what, for 10 years, eh?
And what is interesting about this plane, that the real plane is turboprop.
What is this?
What?
Oh, do you see this, eh?
What?
They have put this inside.
Packaging only.
You have to take it out.
Ah.
Eh, but this is unbelievable. But do you know why this is on? Yes, so this doesn't go off. So the plane is protected. They have gone through tears and pain.
Well, this is the first
time. This is the first time that I see something like this. Are you ready to see for the first time?
Yes.
The most sexy and scale fuselage lately.
Hey.
Tell me that you're not impressed.
Hey.
Tell me.
I'm impressed in this, hey. When you put the wings in, do you see? This connector.
Yeah, hey. Because, do you know how much trouble you have with some planes later if you want to store them during the winter or in your hangar, hey? It's so hard. Many times you give up to take all the wings down and everything. It takes time. Yeah.
Hey, show the front to me, hey. Do you see? Yes.
Huh?
LEDs, look at this. One here and one here.
Now can you imagine how sexy this will look in the dusk, hey? When you will shine yourself with this landing LEDs in the front and LEDs on the wings. I mean, this is amazing. Hey, everywhere you look, look at this perfection, hey. Of course, here goes the wheels, and you can see already here for the, if you will have the floats and the cooling. Uh-huh. Do you see the cooling here? Show the back.
Yes.
Huh? You won't have much work, Captain Blush, on the assembly. I mean, the paint job. Hey, this is it. Now let's check. Oh, what's this, hey? What's this on the front?
Maybe for the camera?
I don't know. Maybe to open, or what's this?
Yeah, yeah. Ah, and like this.
Ah! How do you open?
Yeah. Pull and push. Like, open the hatch.
Oh, hey, wait. Okay, okay. I thought that just this part will open. Yeah, not. Look at this. Yeah, I have my crooked hand, hey. It's really hard. Wait. I will do it like this. Look. Look at this spacious compartment, eh?
Hey, what's this receiver inside?
Hey, this is unbelievable.
Hey, what's this receiver? 6-channel telemetry receiver.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, this is smart.
Oh, Captain Blanche, this is the smart receiver again.
What does it say in the box, eh?
Yeah, it is. Now you can see the smart receiver here. Now, of course, this is the brand new one. We will see and look. I mean, do you know what is amazing, viewers? And I must tell you, look how they have put the antennas. Hey, do you see this?
Spectrum servos.
Spectrum servos. I mean, this is amazing. And look at this. Look at this solution. Hey, where have you seen something like this? I mean, look at this. Hey. Of course, the beautiful compartment for the battery. I will see where to get the CG, how much... I will put it inside here, the EC3 connector, and of course I was trying to tell you how beautiful they have put the solution for the antennas to be on 90 degrees. Now show this to the viewers, because many times we wonder how the hell should we put the antennas inside of the plane to have the good signal. Well, this is it, eh?
This is perfect. Yeah. Just use straws.
It's such a great, you can use the straw, cut it 5 centimeters and glue it on the 90 degrees in your plane and just stuck the antennas inside. I mean, this is some good solution, eh? I love it.
Okay, huh? What's this?
Tell me that you don't love it.
Yes.
What was this? Again, you have the bind. Do you see this?
Yes.
If you want to bind in the safe select and in the normal, and that is what I love, and I will salute them for this. Because they do extend for you the cable, because you know how hard it would be to stuck inside here the bind plug. Eh?
Yes.
I mean, this is a perfection. Eh? This is, viewers, how should I tell you? I'm enjoying this so much. Eh? I'm really enjoying this unboxing so much. Of course, I'll put this away here. So I will put a little together the plane, just a little, so you will see some idea of how it will look later. But of course, I won't do much, because right after this filming, my friends, again, for our convenience and for yours, we will assemble this plane for you. So you will see later, if you will buy this plane, how to assemble, maybe if you need some information. But I can tell you right now that all the information that you need are the instruction manual, and it is so simple that this is unbelievable. I would really love for any pilot that loves foam planes in the world, at least for once, to test the E-Flight plane that they come on the market lately, and you will see this perfection everywhere you look, eh? From the assembly, to the look of the plane, to the quality, eh?
Yes.
Enough.
So this is it?
Stop here, eh?
Yes.
Pilot Robert and Captain Blas signing off from Slovenia with beautiful and sexy E-Flight air tractor that we will fly on the 4-cell, 1.5 meter wingspan. So simple to disassemble and assemble that it is amazing. That can be your first low wing plane to start for. And the scale, not just some phony baloney low wing plane, but the scale low wing plane. And that gives you the ultimate pleasure when you see it fly low, slow, and sexy. Yeah, that's it.
Yes.
So this is it. No, Captain Moshka. Because we must what?
Assemble it as soon as possible.
Assemble this right after this. You will just turn the camera off and I will turn it on right now. Because this plane will be in the air tomorrow. It must be no way. Yes. And I will have so much fun with this. This will be amazing, Greg. So this is yours. Thanks again. Thanks for stopping by. For all your comments, feel at home here. Of course, if you come here, put the thumb up, eh? If we have 20,000, 100,000 views, put the thumb up, because do you know what that means? If I didn't know, Captain Blush, if you put the thumb up, some algorithm on the YouTube will put our video to recommendation to other viewers. Uh-huh. I didn't know that in the past. I mean, I said, but who cares about that thumb up and thumb down? But that makes the difference how much YouTube will promote your video. So if you come here, if you love our videos, if you're our supporter, if you're the lover of Patentius Brothers, well, just that is just one click. It doesn't cost you nothing. Just click, thumb up. Hey, okay, guys, you're doing great. Hey, we want to see more videos. And that's it.
Yes.
Good enough or not, who cares? Captain Blush, what's with you?